So let's begin our webinar officially now. It is a little bit, you know, connectivity issue here. So maybe in some point of view, you may not get me properly, but the streaming is going on quite nicely. So welcome on the board again on the academic writing webinar. I'm Dr. Ajay Semelti from HNB Garhwal University, your course coordinator with you as always, along with the all the team members of academic writings, Mr. Lokesh, Dr. Mona, and all the discussion forum moderators, Dr. Ellery, Dr. Shweta, Dr. Rashmi, and Ms. Subhiksha. So, we're here with you to take the questions. Exam dates, we have been continuously giving you the information that is, the exams have been postponed, and the dates will be announced by the MHRD and the SWAM and the NTA. Then you will be given the all the information on time. Don't worry. If the author is not currently not working where and not a researcher and his career gap, he was written in UP paper, then what is mentioned under the affiliation to the of the author? Friends, the author's affiliations is related with the area in which he has worked. Say for example, I'm preparing a paper of my postdoc work, then I must have that affiliation in that particular paper, even if I'm not working at that particular point of time. Okay. So, graded quiz of week 15 will be given to you, obviously, and we will release it on Friday. Because we have given good number of videos and study material, so I want you to go through all the videos before you attempt the quiz. Okay. That's why intentionally the quiz has not been given so far. Okay. Dr. Dikshit, I think I have answered you. Good morning, Satish. Good morning. No, not at all. No extension will be given because we are running short of time and we have to compile. We have to wrap up the course in the due time. So already we have given the ample of time for the quiz, and for the last quiz, maybe if you say so, we can give. In that case, I can understand that. Okay, I got my point. Sorry, because it's the last week, so maybe today itself I will release. Okay, release. Sorry, because you won't get much time in that case if we put it the last. Okay, maybe we will also extend the last date of the submission of that particular last week quiz. I agree with you. Thanks for pointing it out. Okay. The council exam will be announced. Self plagiarism. Kya hota hai? Self plagiarism is a kind of thing in which I say, for example, I have written a paper. Okay. Self plagiarism is the same thing that you cannot have 2 degrees from a same thesis. Okay, it is kind of self-plagiarism. Okay, you cannot have 2 credits repeatedly for the same work. This is called self-plagiarism. I have written a particular paper, a review paper, and I want to go publish another paper, and I'm procuring most of the things from my previous publication into the next publication and putting some new information. It means I'm doing the self-plagiarism. Okay. You can take 1 figure, 2 figure, that's okay, but that too with the permission of the publisher. I have also mentioned in the module itself that I had to take the permission for my own paper, that I want to reproduce that particular figure which is of interest for a particular review paper, and I had to take the permission from the publisher itself. Incidentally or fortunately, in my case, the publisher was same. The elsewhere was the publisher, so I got the permission very easily. But in some cases, in other cases, you should take prior permission well before the time. Okay, so self-plagiarism is you know, copying yourself again and again. You cannot make an article and give it to the 4 journals simultaneously, and you are having 4 papers. No, no, this is self-plagiarism. Obviously, Jayant ji, I think Jayant ji has already, you know, raised this query in the that YouTube channel. So I remember, I think. answer is yes and maybe no. Why yes and why no? Let's discuss. Yes, because if all the TDS journals are not there in the online, and if your paper is not there available online, you can go for that. Okay. If they are only offline, then obviously you can go. But before going to that republication, you will have to officially send the email to the publisher that I am going to retract this paper. Okay. And you must not send that same paper. You should do some changes at least to for another good journal. Okay. And you can, if asked, you will have to clarify the things to the editor and think that, okay, this is a republication, but the journal doesn't exist now online, so I'm going to publish it if it is asked. Okay. So, and in some cases, if the, because more and many of the TDS journals are giving their contents freely available, so when it is in the, you know, domain, public domain, the plagiarism will detect it, and it will be the case of self-plagiarism. Okay, so you will have to be alert in reproducing your previous papers which are in the TDS journals. And it is sometimes, you know, when you are starting the things, recently I was going through, I will give you example, sorry to extend this answer because it is of universal appeal. Dear learners, what happens that I got a LinkedIn post of a student. She was very enthusiastic and said that I got my first paper published in that particular journal. I won't name that particular journal. And it was having a logo of the, that I, when I went to that particular site, I saw that it is a logo of Elsevier there, and self-declared impact factor is there, though it was established 9 or 10 years back. But and it was written that it it was in the UGC repository, like that. So all these things are misleading. Actually, people, if you are a faculty member, you should be very alert and keep your student alert that don't publish in the journals which are, you know, misleading the people just for the sake of money. So it is our duty. So to, because as using a Elsevier logo, using a Springer logo, using a Bentham Science logo is, you know, punishable offense. It's copyright violation, it is. So don't judge the book by the cover. Go to the details and then identify. I congratulate you that you have identified that okay, these journals are tedious. So be alert and keep other people's alert. Thank you. Next questions. I see the material till week 11 and everything was first better, but I'm trying to log in, but it says I'm not able to. Sorry, Shruti, there is no issue in logging in, but what you might have lost your email ID and from where you are logging in. Okay, what you can do if you haven't done. Yes, sir. Thanks. Good morning, sir. And I also sent a mail asking for my ID and password, but still, because we are not having your ID and password. You are logging in, madam, you are logging in from your credentials, which we are not saving. Okay. If I am enrolling into a SWAM course, I am logging in through my credential or my email ID and my password. How can SWAM help you out? You will have to identify that from which email, from which password you logged in. Understand? I think you should ask yourself. We cannot help you. We don't have any data. Aap jo bhi login kar rahe hai, whatever the login you are doing, we are not saving the credentials of your password and everything. Okay? So the solution is in your hand, not in our parts. Sorry to say. Yes. However, I will try to explore it because, but it is very high time. But you can do, if you have done, then you can send me the email. I will try to force enroll you. Then you will have to attempt all the quizzes again as a learner. Maybe I can help. At last, I can help in that manner. Okay. Okay, Dr. Dilshit, welcome. Sarvesh Kumar. I got your email, Shruti. I have told you. Okay. But those AVs, what is the question pattern for the forthcoming 70 marks exam? It is MCQs. Please, for the general queries, you refer to the FAQs. I have mentioned each and everything in the FAQ on the top of the course dashboard and also in the discussion forum top part. Okay, these are MCQs, 100 MCQs will be there, multiple choice questions, and 3 hours time will be there. Okay, and I will also, for I forget to give you a mock test drill. You go to the NTA website, you can have the mock test of your test. However, you can attempt, you cannot attempt this course mock test, but it is not available in the NTA's website. You can have a mock test, a mock drill, you can say, of your examination, proctored examination, by clicking on a particular link of NTA, which provides other courses like Arpit course. You can go to any other Arpit course link there. I will share that link, okay, through the announcement. So you will attempt the, you will be able to attempt the mock test. Yes. The answer of the 9th question of the D2 assignment week 15 was given both plagiarism. You please check it out. I have corrected it yesterday. Dr. Ellery, our discussion forum moderator, you know, pointed out this thing. It was an error from our side. We have corrected it. Okay. D.B. Jani. Jani sir, very good. Rinki Arora, sir, I am unable to submit the subject assignment 2. What to do? No, subject assignment 2 is open. It last date is 25th of April. It is open. Subject assignment 1 you might not be able because it is closed. But subject assignment 2 you can do. No issue. But if you are trying from your mobile, I have also mentioned earlier that you go to your top 3 dots and go to the desktop version or the, of your website. In that case, you will be able from your mobile also. Okay. I could not find my Rajeshwari could not find paper in Google Scholar through other papers from that journal. I could see what could be the reason. Might be they haven't uploaded your paper in that particular website, or your name is wrong. Is it not matching? What you can do, you can manually add that paper into your Scholar profile. It is also available there. Okay, you can add it manually. Okay, Shruti, thank you. You keep in touch, okay? I'll help you out. I'm writing a paper from Sarvesh is writing for publication. I learned a lot from this course. Thank you, Sarvesh. Greetings, your course cleared so many concepts. thank you, Reena. I think code feedback form we will exclusively we have planned, and we will float it after the end of the course. Meanwhile, you can, whatever the class center link we have given you, maybe for that particular link, you can go to that link, and it is actively, it is available there. You just please logged in there, and you can share your views and rank the course. Thank you. Week 14 quiz available, and week 15 quiz available by evening. Yeah. Ramesh ji, thank you Ramesh, thank you Dr. Ramesh for being with us. Sorry I could point you out at this time only, because I have in the start itself I have welcomed all of you people. And any other DFMs available, please come to the discussion board. Week 13 and 14 graded quizzes, question on statistics question appeared, please. You want to say this is not covered in the thing, na? Why, Dr. Satish, please clarify your question. What is happening in our case? Nowadays, when we are teaching online learning and when we are engaged in the online learning, it is utmost desired, first of all, to go through your week 2. Academic English, it is utmost important to write a good English, because if I have spoken to you sometimes, many times we do the grammatical errors and other things in spoken, in a casual language it is okay, but when we are writing a thing, everything must be correct, especially when you are a faculty member, and even when you are writing students. My students used to report me and question me, then I first, before answering their queries, I correct their English, I correct their grammar. So you can take the help of Grammarly, Baba. Grammarly is available there. Grammarly software, and you can put it into your desktop. You put it into your, you can connect it into your email. It will correct your language grammatically, and it will look professional. you are writing a cover paper and you are for a journal and you are making 10-12 mistakes in the five seven lines. What the editor will do? Editor will do the namaskar to your paper and will send back to you. Okay, so that's why these things does count, dear. People won't go for your paper. They will just see the cover paper. Sometimes it happens, and before and with the, even if they are going to for the checking of your paper, so they will have a perception in your mind based on your cover paper. So it's on you to plan the things effectively. So writing good, effective English is an art as well as a science. So it must be kept in mind. You cannot do these kind of mistakes when you are planning for writing the papers. Okay, Rashmi, welcome. Yeah, Dr. Rashmi, welcome. So complete your thank you sir, Sharvan. So thank you, Dikshit sahab. Anything else, sir? Can you discuss some more on research proposal writing, Gayatri? Research proposal writing, you go actually, research proposal writing. Actually, one thing I would like to answer before Gayatri, please remind me the question. I'm going little bit away from the topic. That many people used to say that it would have been better if you have addressed the research related, how to plan the paper for psychology, how to plan the paper for the agriculture. You know, this is the course. You can understand my limitation, that I cannot address each and every subject domain. In no course in the world can address each and every discipline. What we have done, I think most of you will agree with me, that what we are giving you is our basic framework. In the introduction, you go to the introduction of this course, what we have mentioned, that implementation part is yours. Okay, I cannot guarantee you that doing this, after doing this course, you will be an academic writer, उद्यमे नहि सिद्ध्यन्ति कार्याणि न मनोरथे नहि प्रविशति मुखे मृगा. कहते कि सोते हुए सिंह के मुंह में भी जो है मृग तब तक नहीं जाता जब उद्यम नहीं करते. यू हैव टू प्रैक्टिस इट. अंटिल यू डू द प्रैक्टिस यू कैन नॉट राइट. एंड फॉर प्रैक्टिसिंग नो पीपल नो कोर्स कैन गिव यू कैन मेक यू द एकेडमिक राइटर. यू विल हैव टू इन जस्ट बाय डूइंग द कोर्स यू कैन नॉट बी ए गुड राइटर. So I'm coming back to the research proposal, and I had tried to address all the disciplines as much as possible. Because of my multidisciplinary approach, I have been engaged in research in chemistry, in pharmacy obviously is my core, management I have done, that's why I have the concept of the marketing management, and operation research was my specialization, and I'm doing some work in the nuclear reactors, in physics, material physics work I'm working. So I have got the multidisciplinary approach. That's why I think I would have been able to communicate the things for maximum disciplines. As far as the research proposal is concerned, for the research proposals, it is a very difficult task to write for them. Each and every word does count. First line, undercode. This is a big massive. You cannot fill the big mesh in the research proposal. Research proposals, origin of idea, number one. What does help you? What creates an idea in your mind? What was the origin, the solid origin of idea in a one para, two para, in 100 words, 200 words, and the word limit are always mentioned there. And then you come to what is your significance of your studies? What is the summary of your study you will plan? And then methodology, what you will put objective first, after the origin of idea, what is your hypothesis, then you will put the aim and objective, and then you will give the methodology. That what is the key, that your methodology should match with the objectives. Sometimes it happens you are taking the objectives here and there, and your methodology is going here and there, and you are trying to conclude something else. So this will be in good cohesion and coherence. That coherence, idea level framework must be there. If anything is missed, your proposal will be disposed of. Budgeting is very important. You cannot ask lakhs and lakhs of rupees for a simple work. It is reviewed by the experts who are the expert of that particular field. They know what is needed for that work. So your demand must be rational. Okay. I think we'll go for the next question. Gayatri, you might have got your answer. Can you discuss some more research proposal? Gayatri, you got your answer. Week 13 and 14 graded quiz question or statistics question appeared. Please look into the matter. No content covered during these 2 weeks. Dr. Satish, it is you're taking week 13 and 14, and we have entered into week 15. You know, if you are a faculty member, you might know that when we plan assessment plan, there are different kind of strategies. One kind of question are recall level question, that whatever has been called, you just have to recall. 2 2s are 4, 2 4s are 8, like that. It has been taught already, you just have to give the answers. Some questions are the are called the, you know, analytical questions, and some are called the, you know, assimilating questions, that what have you got and have you gone through for the further readings or not. It is, you know, it is triggering you to read something more. This is the purpose. You know, it is not an open book examination. If you want to improve, you will have to do the thing, and because it is not there, completely untouched question are there. Something related to that have been discussed for sure. Okay. However, it might not have been elaborated. I have answered this question in the discussion forum, especially I remember, by another learner's question, I have answered it. So this is an assimilating question. You will have to improve. In PG, like in PG, we planned a question not just by the textbook. We give the questions which are triggering the analytical attitude. We are seeing that how much you have absorbed, how much you have gone for the further reading. Okay. Yeah. By following the model, students can follow it. Yeah, good. Okay, Dr. Mona is also here with us. Thank you so much, sir, for your expertise. Thank you. Publish a good research paper. I welcome you all to utilize this question, utilize this time, lockdown time, for writing good papers, good plan, good review papers, plan good research article. Anything, any other questions, please? And one thing, whenever the examinations registration are on, I request you all to register yourself, okay, and get part and do participate in the examination, because your journey of learning will be fulfilled only when you will be giving the examination, passing the examination. Don't worry at all about the passing the examination. It is going to be a very simple task for you. If you have, because the purpose of this course is to induce a culture of writing, induce a kind of confidence in you that you can write. You have to practice. This is just my motto. You know, getting a paper, getting a certificate is another issue. Okay, don't worry at all. You will pass anyhow. Even if you don't study at all, you go to the exam. If you have gone through the videos, I promise you that you will pass the exam. But remember, you will have to attain at least 40% in proctored exam and 40% in intern exam, then only you will get the certificate. Okay, it is not like that the earlier version. In the earlier cycle, the rule were different, but now it has somewhat stringent. So 40% not in total, 40% internal, 40% external. So Srinivasan sir, I do my subject assignment right in Tamil language with plagiarism report. So plagiarism, have you done in Tamil? Isn't it? Okay, I'll try to explore it. Okay, Srinivasan. Ji, languages, I welcome. You write in language, no issue. Okay. Budget advice, Gayatri, budgeting should be rational. First, you see how much budget is generally given for that particular scheme. And your budgeting will be reaching or within that particular limit, okay? And budgeting should, you see the pattern of budgeting given earlier, and you see the maximum allowed in a particular head. Your budgeting must be good. And I advise you, if you are a budding researcher, you don't ask for a JRF. You ask for equipments rather than going for the JRF, research fellows. Because if you will have, in the initial research project, if you will have the equipments, you can build up your own lab in your institute. Okay. Otherwise, taking a research fellow helps only when you are having your own lab. You cannot be dependent upon complete on the, your institute. So if you will take the JRF, your entire salary will go to the JRF. I agree that research fellows are utmost necessary. But in the beginning, you must go for maximum number of equipment. Because the budget is same, 50 lakhs say for example. Then if you will go for a project fellow salary, 12 lakhs will be directly debited to the research fellow salary. But had it been the case, you haven't asked for the research fellow and you say that I need the 12 lakh this instrument. Surely you will get if you are not asking for the research fellow. This happens. Okay, this is the key. Now, Namrata, of course, you can continue the course. You can complete the all the quizzes. You can submit the second subject assignment. Okay, so you can upload research paper and review paper. This is a question or answer? You can upload research paper and review paper. No, research paper and review paper, you can, for as far as the uploading is concerned, you must see the copyright agreement, what you have signed. If the copyright agreement allows, you can upload it. And if it doesn't allow, what you can do, you can have the final version. In any case, you can in the MS Word office, the final version before the review, you can upload with the link of the final published paper. Okay, this you can do. Otherwise, you are not supposed to upload a paper which is available on the paid basis only by their particular publisher. It will be the violation of the copyright. My email ID, I think. You write to the that domain ID. It's wherever my ID is mltajay@gmail.com. I'm writing an edited book chapter. I plan to include few of my published data in it. The credit will be given. In that case, you can give the hint. You can discuss them, but you cannot write the complete research paper there as a chapter. Remember this thing. We want to make use of this lockdown period, as it says. But don't have choice to do that. What we have to complete our syllabus online education. Yeah, of course. But how many hours you are teaching online? 1 hour, maybe 2 hours. What about the other thing? What about the other time? You know, friends, either you are faculty member or students, there are always excuses. Excuses are always there. You know, myself, sometimes I want to have leisure time. I have always ample of excuses before me. But if I want to work, I will have to go ahead with the time. You know, if you'll don't work, 100% and then a bit of extra, you won't get that actual result. You will have to be sincere. Sorry to say. I went to bed 2 a.m. in the night yesterday. Preparing something and then wake up at 8 o'clock and I'm here at 10 o'clock. I was in the department for interacting with you, and after 12 I am having the meetings up to the 3 p.m. All the online meetings are there. No excuses. You cannot have excuses. Work and work. Until you practice, you cannot have good results. So, thank you. So, how an individual or PhD scholar create plagiarism report for the pre-submission of thesis free of cost? So first, if you have gone through the plagiarism issue, what Madam had discussed, Dr. Mona has discussed, that you should be in contact with your supervisors, and if you are in universities, they are having Urkund ID, or might be some good universities are also having Turnitin subscriptions. If you are a good researcher or if you are a good writer, you can even buy the Turnitin subscription, isn't it, Lokesh? Hello. So we can do these things. So let me connect Which is preferably to do, writing a research paper or edit a chapter or for a better API? Everything okay? Okay, well, I got disconnected now. Which is preferable to do, writing a research paper or edited paper for a better paper? Which is preferable to writing a research paper or edited chapter? You know, edited chapters. That's fine, that's fine. Okay. No issue. You know, in my opinion, going for the research paper is good because research paper has got the reach. What happens that these books, I was in a central library, a book exhibition was there. It has become a business that you give your research paper as an edited chapter and they will be compiled in a form of book. You will get a ISBN number chapter book for just for sake of API. But actually they are not being sold. I was a member there to choose the book there. So hardbound and 150 pound book, 30 pound book, 10 pound book, these kind of books are there. They are not reaching, you know, just for the sake of publishing a chapter book, you can write, but you won't have citations for that particular chapter. But for research paper, you will have good citation. It will increase your H index. But for chapter book, you won't have citations much. Okay. I think I have answered your question. Where I submit an article for sometimes without any comment, they reject. How to find, am I eligible for submission in that journal? Rajalakshmi, what happens that if then article is not at all in the scope of that particular journal, they immediately reject it. Actually, they are not rejecting it. They are finding it unfit in the scope of that particular journal. The scope is not there. So that's why they think. So what you have to do, you first survey that whether the journal is having the similar kind of research papers or not. Okay. So in that way we can plan, okay, that journal is having similar research paper or not, and then only you go for the manuscript submission in that particular journal. Okay. So many journal demand similarity index only 5% excluding references. How to achieve this? This is for research paper, it is very easy. You paraphrasing you have to do. You have, if you are unique, you have done the research work, you doesn't need. Actually, the problem arises only in the review papers. However, 5% is a typical task, I understand. Up to 10% it may be okay, but going for 5%, especially when you have taken the methodology and all that thing, it is very typical to get the thing. And I think the 5% question, you will see the journals which don't know much about the plagiarism ask for this kind of things. Okay, because whenever you are taking the methodology section, many of the things comes, and even the footnotes if you take, even in the some standard text you take, even in the standard methodology you take, it will be covered under the plagiarism. So it is very typical, I agree with you, that taking down the plagiarism below 5% is a big challenge. But anyhow, you have to do. If you are unable to do, change the journal. Okay. Satish, sir, I'm writing some article and I want to, for the bottom editor, Surji, thank you. Okay, thanks. Sir, I'm writing some article and I want to use some study abstract in my article. How much part of and then abstract I can use to save myself from plagiarism? Plagiarism from the same abstract. I'm writing some article and I want to use some study abstract in my article. Okay, abstract, you cannot copy as such. For abstract, you will have to take the idea that what do you want from that particular article. So this way you can do. There is no solution that you will have to write in your own words, because you have no other alternative. You cannot copy the exact abstract. You can copy it maybe a few lines, but not more than that. But that to undercode. How to check the journal? Many journals show good indexing list but found wrong. How will I know with a genuine one? Rajeshwari, you must go to the indexing agency site they are claiming to. Like SCI gave the indexing, the journal list of journals which are indexed with them. elsewhere, give the indexing there. You can ask them, by they will certainly help you out. And with the passage of time, you will, when you will get the experience, and they, you see the, for the biomedical, you see the PubMed. If they are escape, they are claiming that they are indexing elsewhere, they are indexing Scopus, you just go to the PubMed NCBI website, you type that particular thing. If you won't get it, it's not there, because in 99% of the cases, Scopus journal, Scopus index journal are there in PubMed in case of biomedical. Okay, so by the way, value, there are so many ways. Vandana madam, thank you. Thank you for joining us. So we are having Professor Vandana Panda on board from KM Kundani College of Pharmacy. Welcome ma'am for being with us. So I don't understand anything about this subject, but I'm trying to do the quizzes. Of course you do it. If we submitted the assignment only once, then only will be, out of two, I will be taking best one. If you have submitted only one, we will take that one only. So even if you have submitted only one, it will be counted and you won't have any loss. Similarity index can be considered including references, excluding the references. Yeah, of course, references are not counted in the similarity. Remember this thing. What are the criteria for opting service for editor in SCI journal? What are the criteria for opting service for editor in SCI journal in terms of number of papers or H index? For editing services, you please ask for the SCI index journal, that particular journal. Because it is not like that you are applying for being the editor. Only a few journals practice this kind of thing. Otherwise, the editorship is offered. Okay, it is not by application. It is by offered only. It is offered on the basis of your credentials. Good journals practice this thing. And I remember that there's some TDS journal also provided, because many people will love that researcher like Professor Vandana Panda, they would love to have her in their editorial board, but she cannot go there. Isn't it, Professor Vandana? Because they know that she is cited by lot many researchers, you know. So she will be there in their editor board, it will increase their repo. But actually her repo will go down if she will be associated with the lower level of journals. Okay, you got my point? So remember this thing. I think UGC has also, in academic integrity rule, they have also mentioned that the researchers must not be associated with these kind of predatory journals in their editorial board and all that. Sometimes it may be the case if the journals are found, completely frivolous or taking the money, some actions may also be taken on that particular researcher who is on academic advisory board or editorial board. Okay. It is just like if a company for which I am doing an advertisement and doing wrong things, I am also responsible for that, isn't it? Because I am advertiser of that particular thing. Yeah. Is the project outcome expected to be a patent or some good papers? No, project outcome, if a patent you are doing, it's a wonderful thing, obviously. Yeah? But even generally, the project outcome are either the publications, number one, in the form of papers, review papers, research papers, conference papers. Okay. Secondly, if patent is good, perfect. Third, a product you have developed. Fourth, a technology you have developed. So these are four kind of outcomes. And policy, you can also frame the policy in the social sciences research. You can go with a policy for the government as expected outcome. Okay. UGC care journals follow plagiarism. This is a good question to ask from the UGC. UGC drops a journal which generally does the wrong things. That's why it's a dynamic list. So generally the journals are supposed to, but UGC is not monitoring the thing. If the case comes into their table, they take the action. Okay. So UGC is not responsible for taking the plagiarism. Actually, UGC is having the monitoring activity there. That's why you will be seeing that many of the journals which were there 2 years back or 1 year back in their list are not there, not at this time. Yeah. Difference between indexing and impact factor. Please go to the journal thing. It's a simple question. Impact factor, it's a rank. Impact factor is your depending on your number of publication and that particular journal's number of number of papers cited. Indexing services, because indexing are services there, and index basically is a benchmark. Impact factor is a benchmark of indexing. Okay, you can say that. Impact factor is generally of one type indexing. So, so many types of indexing services are there. Impact factor, maybe you can opt either JCR impact factor or these Scopus that site score like Copernicus indexing kind. Okay, thank you. thank you, Dr. Vandana. Thank you, Professor Vandana. Namrata, I have already published parts of my ongoing research paper in two papers. Do I have to cite myself? Obviously, you should cite in final thesis. You can do, obviously. Could you please? Self-plagiarism, I have already. Please see the recording in the article. I think you have joined us late. Rajalakshmi Mahindran, when will be the exam tentatively? It has been postponed. I cannot say anything. The government has to decide, MHRD has to decide, NT has to decide, and we will communicate you. We will keep you posted on that particular thing. Okay? UGC CARE, I think we are running out of time now. It's 11:55. So in 5 minutes, we will wrap the things because I have to go for the meetings after 12. Okay? So 1-2 minutes only, and you can see the recording after that. Okay? Should we co-author a paper with unknown person? No, not at all. You should not go for the unknown person. Just dekhiye, gift nahi hai. It is not a gift of taking authorship. You know, one of a fellow, I won't name I won't name the affiliation. He was a supervisor. What happened that his student, a girl, published a paper, taking my paper. And just copied completely and just changed the name of the drug and published in a journal. Okay. And I just happened to see after 1 year that it is just a copied one that I just claimed that the supervisor is a very good academician, was in very typical condition. He was the first author as well as the corresponding author. And he said that I have nothing to do with that thing because that girl did. Is he supposed to do in that thing? You can't say anything. वो कहते हैं ना हिंदी में ना 3 महीना 13 महीने यार फंस जाएंगे आप काम का. तो ऐसे काम नहीं करने हैं हमको कि जो हमारी एकेडमिक इंटीग्रिटी पे क्वेश्चन मार्क हो जाए. कि एकेडमिक इंटीग्रिटी इज वेरी मच डन. यू अर्न दैट इंटीग्रिटी विद द पैसेज ऑफ टाइम, बट यू विल लूज इट इन फ्रैक्शन ऑफ सेकेंड. ओके, सो बी अलर्ट इनवाइटिंग द ऑथरशिप और इन टेकिंग द ऑथरशिप एज अ गिफ्ट. ओके, how to take permission from author whose material is copyrighted. You are not supposed to take the copyright permission from author. You should take, because generally the copyright in the case of articles, the copyright is with publisher. You should take the copyright from the publisher. If author says, if I say you can take my article, then no, I am not supposed, because I have given the copyright, the rights to the publisher. The rights are not with me for my article even. Okay. For research work, one should be a summary of the research that is compulsory. Out of 4 publication of our research work, one should be once on summary of the research that is compulsory. Okay, you can do that. From an author whose material is copyrighted, how to take permission from an author? I have answered, Kailash. Okay. Does the statement of problem and the research topic, if not, how do they differ? Sir, if you guide a little about reference and work cited while... देखिए रीना, प्लीज गो थ्रू द वीक 2 day 3. आई थिंक वी हैव डिस्कस द रेफरेंसिंग द APA, MLA एंड व्हाट इज द बिग 3. सो दीज बिग 3 स्टाइल्स वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन दैट थिंग, एंड डिपेंडिंग ऑन द जर्नल्स क्राइटेरिया यू कैन अडॉप्ट एनी रेफरेंसिंग स्टाइल. ओके, थैंक यू फॉर शेयरिंग. थैंक यू विशाल. थैंक यू डॉक्टर सतीश. Priyadarshini, but it is not answered. Please, Priyadarshini, what you are selling? Sorry, I skipped your question. Please repeat your question. Kya tha, Lokesh? Can you help me out? Priyadarshini's question. She said that I asked twice. No, I have. Yeah, dekhiye. Self-plagiarism if you are writing a book, you know, and you are supposed to take the permission from your publisher where you have published the paper, Priyadarshini. Obviously, it is a self-plagiarism, but you will have to write it in a different form. You can procure a particular figure there. You can take the figure there, but with the permission of that particular publisher only. Okay, it is plagiarism, no issue. It is a plagiarism, but you will have to take the due permission. And then when you are writing that in below that in a footnote that it has been with due permission to adapt from this. So then you can skip the plagiarism. Okay. Even if you are writing your own editing paper, you edited a book from your, you are taking the material from your own paper. Okay. Thank you, Anji. Dr. Dishit, thanks for clarification. Okay, Priyadarshini. Okay, I would like to take your permission of the house. It's 12 p.m. and I have to go for a meeting with my administration. Thanks a lot for being with us. Please practice and give your valued feedback to the link which we are providing again and again, please. And we request you to come back with the good papers and wait for the good papers. Don't be impatient, because publishing in a tedious journal is a double-edged sword. Okay, so remember, wait and practice the writing until you get good papers. Okay, and it is not always the papers. If you can get the patent, if you can have the novelty, just go firstly for that thing, then go for the publication. Okay, so this is my final message. Thank you, dear friends. Thank you for being with us. Now I would like to take your permission. And lastly, as we always said, happy learning, keep learning, and be with us. Thank you for being with us in this journey of learning. Thank you. Bye.